Hi everybody, I want you to pause this video and read example one. Okay. Now how do we solve this problem? First, we have to write the given values, the quantities, and the values assigned to each quantity. So in the problem, the total capital money is 24,000 pesos, and three persons are sharing the money, who are Annie, Feli, and Jessa. And the ratio of their shares or part is 1:2:3. Now, the next part is to know what is asked in the problem. Let's go back to the problem. The ask is, how much does each of them need to invest? Meaning, you are asked to give the amount of money each person, Annie, Feli, and Jessa, need to invest. The next part is to know what are the steps we need to take. In this kind of problem, the first step is to identify, as stated here in number one, identify the total shares. The total amount is divided into. How many parts is 24,000 divided into? Number two is how much amount is one share or one part? Lastly is the ask, which is how much money does each person need to invest. In other words, we need to get first the total parts or shares and then the amount of one share. So let's illustrate the problem. Shall we say the total capital money is presented or represented through this small rectangle? So that is 24,000. And then again, the total parts or the 24,000 is divided into parts. For Annie, that is 1. For Feli, 2 parts. And then for Jessa, 3 parts. Again, the first step is to find the total parts. To find the total parts, we just need to add 1 and 2 and 3. And the result is 1 + 2 = 3, 3 + 3 = 6. That means the total parts, the 24,000 pesos is divided into 6. Okay? So we know already that 24,000 is divided into 6 parts. The next thing to do is to know how much amount is one part. In other words, we need to divide 24,000 by how many parts it is divided into. How many? It's actually divided by 6 to get the amount of each part. And what's the amount? If we will divide 24 by 6, the answer is 4,000 pesos. Therefore, each part or each box is equivalent to 4,000 pesos. Now let's proceed to the next step, the third one. We are now in the part wherein we need to solve the individual money each person need to invest. We know already that 24,000 is divided into 6 parts. As you can see, there are 6 boxes. And each part is 4,000 pesos. The question is, how much will Annie give for the investment? That means 4,000 only, represented by the yellow box. We could get that one by revisiting the ratio of each person. The ratio or the number or the term corresponding to each person. So we have Annie, 1 only, that's why 4,000 times 1 is equal to 4,000. And for Feli, how much money? It should be 8,000 because 4,000 times 2, that's 8,000. And for Jessa, we can get 12,000 because Jessa will get 3 parts and we multiply it with 4,000, that means 12,000. So